Killing me softly with this song. No. Not with a song, but with leadership failures. Forbes headlines, Killing Me Softly. Leadership failure at Sara Lee. A story of how a global consumer goods company failed after endless turnarounds. You can see at first glance, Yannis has done a very thorough analysis. He knows exactly what he's talking about, and this is so critical for presentations. And if you're the real expert, it opens up completely new opportunities, to which I get back to in a minute. Further, Yannis keeps a very consistent look and feel of his presentation, with a very clear four-point structure. And the four chapter slides match one-to-one with his agenda slide. I'm highlighting this as it often isn't the case, which in turn confuses the listeners. So always keep this consistent. Good job, Yannis. What I learned on those kind of finance presentations is that they often contain lots of facts and figures, which can make them very dry. On the other hand, the story could be very exciting and insightful, like in this case. So how can we make it peppier? Let me present a radical idea. Cutting 80% of the slides, down from 35 to just 7. One of the most critical parts of an entire presentation is the start. That is the time your audience decides if your talk will be exciting or not. So you have to catch their immediate attention. Going through the agenda is probably not the best idea. So why not start with a question? A question that engages your audience. Can you cost cut your way to greatness? And then you do a poll. Ask for a show of hands. Who thinks that this will work out? And then you react to the responses. All right, most of you think it won't work. Let's have a look at a thrilling example to see who is right. Actually, an example with three trials. All good things come in threes. Really? See, a very different approach versus starting with the agenda. And then I would shortly introduce whom we are talking about. Yannis uses these two slides for it. He uses pictures and text. Pictures are great because they catch the immediate attention, which you probably recognize. But the facts here are a bit too detailed. So my suggestion would be making one slide out of the two with a dramatic reduction of the content. And this is where we refer back to the comment that Yannis knows what he's talking about. Put as little as possible on the slide and mention the rest verbally. You may not even say everything. And in case somebody asks for more details, you know them and you can answer directly. This lets you look like the real expert. It gives you much more authority than having all the details on the slides. And then comes the history and the current situation with these five slides. Also here, reduce to the max and only show the information that is relevant for the turnaround in this case. For example, like this. All other details are mentioned verbally as you show the slide. In 1997, they did this. Only 3 years later, the next turnaround. This happened. And then just another 5 years later, the third turnaround. What was the plan in the third turnaround? And out of the many slides Yannis is using, I would just pick this one, the SWOT analysis. And the question on this slide is, can we do with less? Yes, we can. Just highlight the critical parts and explain the rest. Now, my radical proposal would go one level further. I would just highlight the issues. When we look at Sara Lee and at the performance, we see four key issues. First, they are too diversified with a far too broad product portfolio. They are too decentralized with a lot of duplication in work and cost. And they are too detached from customers and from consumers. And finally, they are too directionless. They lack a clear vision and a growth strategy. With just a few points on this slide, you can provide sufficient background and also show how much expertise, how much insights you have. And now comes the plan. Also on the plan, less is more. On my radical idea, just focus on how the leadership addresses the issues. They want to reduce layers, they want to reduce portfolio, and they want to reduce the locations. And here you can already inject your conclusion. If your only focus is on reduction, how should your business grow? And the result is, across all those three turnarounds, the profits go southwards. And you see, with this nice morph animation, you even visually support your point. Yannis uses this chart to explain it. And on this chart, he has a nice quote at the bottom, which comes from this Forbes article, Killing Me Softly. My recommendation would be, show the quote like this. You can't cost cut, refocus, or realign your business to success. You have to grow it. And this nicely links back to our initial question. Can we cost cut our way to greatness? No, we cannot. It's killing me softly. That's exactly what happened. You probably recognized that the picture here also disrupts the rather monotonic text that I used on the other slides. With these six radically reduced slides, you will definitely surprise your audience. And then you can go one level further by sharing an insight that I didn't find in literature about this case. And that's about people. Almost all reviews I've seen, they share excessive facts and figures. But what about the people? No sales without people. No sales without motivated coworkers producing the products. No sales without customers selling them. And certainly no sales without consumers buying them. And then you can talk about the challenges of customers, of unhappy customers, having to deal with too many different layers and independent divisions at Sara Lee. Unsatisfied consumers, not finding the products meeting their needs. Or you talk about uncertain coworkers that have gone through several turnarounds and several relocations. Give me a break. What about them? You can't win without a winning team. All in all, this is my radical reduction idea. That's it for today. If you find these tips useful, just click on subscribe. And if you want help with your presentation, send it to me and we will have a look at it. See you and bye-bye.